today I will talk about what is anxiety and how to cope with it. Imagine that you are getting ready to go to a party or somewhere you feel excited but also nervous. There's something holding you back from getting happy, and you start wondering, who should I talk to when I get there? What if no one wants to talk to me? What if they all think I'm weird? When you arrive at the party, someone comes up to you and starts talking with you, and then your mind starts racing. Your heart begins pounding. You start sweating. After a few minutes of conversation, the person you have been speaking to leaves and you feel utterly defeated. This has been happening to you in social situations for a long time. When you're surrounded by lots of people, you start to feel hot, nauseous, uneasy. And to prevent this from happening, you start avoiding a lot of places, which makes you feel lonely and isolated. And what can I tell you is that anxiety is very common, much more than people think. And also, anxiety can lead to depression, social drop, school drop out, and even suicide. A reason why so many people don't think it's important is that they don't know what it is. There are two types of anxiety. Normal anxiety is the emotion we all get when we are in stressful situations. People with generalized anxiety disorder worry excessively and constantly think about everything going on in their lives. They also have symptoms like restlessness, fear, and they find it hard to fall asleep at night, and they can't concentrate on tasks. Now, I will talk about some coping resources to lower our anxiety. First one is feeling like you are in control of your life. People who feel like they're more control of their life have better mental health. We want to do something perfectly. We want to do something perfectly, but we can't start until it's the perfect time, until we have got all the skills. But this can be stressful, so why not just jump into it, just do it however, without worrying if it's good or bad. Second coping strategy is to forgive yourself. And this is very powerful if you use it. People with anxiety think a lot about what are they doing, their worries, and how bad they're feeling. People with anxiety are not kind to themselves. So maybe it's time to start being kinder with ourselves. Time to supporting ourselves. If you have a panic attack and are embarrassed about it, just forgive yourself. And the last strategy that I can tell is having a purpose and meaning in life. You will know the why for your existence, and you will be able to bear it almost anyhow. I would like to conclude with this another way you can do something with someone else in mind is finishing work that might benefit future generations. Even if these people will never realize what you have done for them, it doesn't matter. It literally doesn't matter, because you will know, and this will make you realize the uniqueness and importance of your life. And the last thing I'm gonna say is that you are so strong than you think. So just never give up, like never give up, and believe in yourself, and just don't forget there are a lot of people that who are believing in you. for listening to me.